Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to be in the house of the Lord, amen. And it's good to be with God's people, amen. We've come into his house today to worship and praise him with our song, our prayer, and our heart. Amen. So let's have church.
Couple of weeks since I've seen you from up here, so it's nice to see all your smiling faces today. I believe that fall is upon us. The weather temperatures are a little cooler, and so I think we can actually think that hot summer might be behind us, which would be a great thing. Let me share a few announcements with you from this morning. The adult Sunday school meets every Sunday morning at 9:30. As I did some background on the announcements this morning, I was told that this meets in Jack Kimple's Sunday school room. And I know where that is, so that goes back a long way. Choir practice every Thursday at 6:30, right, Steve? Isn't that correct?
Yes, it is.
Good deal.
Yes, it is.
The next Parents of Addicted Loved Ones meeting is going to be Thursday, October 13th here at the church from 6 to 7:30. October 11th is a ham dinner, which is a great thing if you're a single guy like me and you don't really like to cook. It's always a good thing to do. I also checked on this next announcement. The next announcement says SPRC meeting September 28th at 4 o'clock. I guess, and I was correct, that Staff Parish Relations Committee? Yeah, not bad, huh?
Yeah.
About a billion years ago, I was a student representative on the Parish Relations Committee, so probably that's how I remember it. And then that same committee will consult with the district superintendent on October 16th at New Waterford at 1:15. I assume that's probably a larger group meeting, yeah, Pastor? About other churches?
DS consultation is just what the SPRC of Columbiana offers. The charge conference is actually with the larger group.
Okay, but so we rotate into the New Waterford Church is what the plan is.
That's just where the DS is holding the consultations this year.
Excellent. October 16th is a Christ Unlimited, I think that's a musical group, right?
Yeah.
It's here at Columbiana First Church at 6:30, so you wouldn't want to miss that. And then finally, as we just mentioned, the charge conference is coming up on October 29th at the Elizabeth Methodist Church at 9 a.m. Any other announcements from the... Yes, ma'am.
Our kids club is officially starting this Tuesday, 6 to 7:30. If you know anyone with some children from kindergarten to sixth grade, just have them show up. We'll be done in the fellowship hall. Thank you.
Fall is officially with us. Get you back in classes. Any other announcements coming from the congregation today? Okay. Well, if you would join me in our opening prayer. Father in heaven, King of glory, we adore your name and work to glorify you forever. It is through your will that we are alive and healthy today. Your grace has allowed us to congregate together. You have promised that whenever we call on your name, you will hear and answer us. Come into our midst, God, and have fellowship with us. Make your blessings abundant and grace us with your presence. From the start of this meeting to the end, glorify yourself and accept our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Opening hymn is number 158.
Will the congregation and the choir please stand?
Joy to sing, hallelujah.
Those who love God,
God will deliver.
Those who know God by name,
God will protect.
Those who call out to God,
God will answer.
We gather this morning
as those who trust God.
Amen. Thank you.
Do we have any prayer requests, praises, concerns?
Pastor.
Oh. Judy?
Yeah. My son Bruce is traveling from Shanghai to Chicago. He needs to come visit us. And this is the first time he's been out of China since Christmas time of 19.
So you're asking for traveling mercies for your son Bruce? Yes. Steve.
Yeah, we need to pray for Franklin Graham, who's saying that will be Tuesday in Youngstown near the Catholic Center.
In the amphitheater.
Right, the amphitheater.
I want to give thanks for my neighbor that was hit by the car. Is doing pretty well, and she's able to put weight on her left side now, so continue prayers.
There is a young boy that I know that lives in North Carolina. I'm not sure how old he is, but I'm pretty sure he's either in late 20s or early 30s. But anyways, he got in a car accident a few days ago, and he was hurt pretty bad, so he's in the hospital with recovery. So his name is Tyler Coulter. So if you would keep him in prayer, not only today, but anytime his name comes across your mind or heart, please stop and pray for him and his family.
My prayers for my son aren't nearly as dramatic as your son's travel from Shanghai. But my son is officiating at a wedding this morning, or this afternoon actually, in Greenville, South Carolina, with some very good friends. And so prayers that God will bless that marriage and bless that service.
Okay, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, dear Heavenly Father, we come into your house this morning to praise your name and worship you with all of our heart, our mind, and our soul. Thank you for loving us so much that you would sacrifice your only son for us. Thank you for giving us second chances. You knew that we would fail, and you have given us a way to be redeemed. So thank you for redeeming us. We need you. And you are always there for us. We come to you with heavy hearts, with troubled hearts, with joyful hearts, or seeking a joyful heart. We come to you with many things, because we know, dear Lord, that you are there for us. You will fill our needs, and we will get that joy that only you can bring. We do join Judy in asking for traveling mercies for her son, dear Lord. We put him in your hands, asking you to put your hand of protection upon him, allowing him to reach his destination safely, dear Lord, and knowing, dear Lord, that you are the one that got him there. We join Steve in lifting up the Franklin Graham Crusade, dear Lord. We ask that you pour your Holy Spirit upon that place. Go before all others so that everyone that shows up, dear Lord, will feel your presence. And we ask that you fill Franklin and all those that will be sharing your word with your spirit, so that they can allow all those that come to know you or know you better. We join Anne in praising your name for the recovery that her neighbor Lori has gotten, dear Lord, able to put weight on her leg, dear Lord, which we don't even know how great of an accomplishment that is, but you do. So we lift up to her, you to her, dear Lord, her to you, dear Lord, and ask that you just continue to walk with her and extend your healing hand upon her, allowing not just her to know that you're near, but all those that she comes across. We join Dave in lifting up his son, dear Lord, as he prepares to officiate a wedding. We know, dear Lord, how important a wedding is to you. So we ask you, dear Lord, to show up there also. Fill Dave's son with your spirit and allow him to represent you. And we ask that you bless this marriage, dear Lord, and let not any man come between it and what you put together. Dear Heavenly Father, we live in a world that is just turned upside down. We watch the news, dear Lord, and we get confused and frustrated. But we know, dear Lord, that you are there for us. So we ask you, dear Lord, to help us to change the world. I know that seems like a big ask, dear Lord, but you are so much bigger than that. Guide us in our thoughts, dear Lord. Guide us in our actions, so that the people that get frustrated and confused as to what they hear will know that you are near, and there is still good in this world, and you are the one that brings it through us. I ask you, dear Lord, to help us have the right words to say and the right actions to do. Help us, dear Lord, be the church that you want us to be. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. If you would join me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you. once again for the blessings that you continue to pour upon each and every one of us. I thank you, dear Lord, for the gifts that have been given back. I ask you, dear Lord, to bless these gifts. Continue to bless the givers. And allow us, dear Lord, to use these gifts in a way that is pleasing to you. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
God of justice and mercy, we come to worship you this day as one too on the great balance scale of your creation. Our more like the rich man in the gospel story than we are Lazarus. The parable Jesus tells reminds us that the gap between the rich and poor is hard to cross in the life to come, but not so for us this day. As we strive to see God's kingdom at work in our world, as we offer gifts today, may we do so, strive to be
not the plague that destroys at midday.
Because he loves me, said the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. May God bless the reading of this holy word.
The gospel reading today comes from Luke chapter 16, verses 19 through 31. There was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen and fared sumptuously every day. But there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, full of sores, who was laid at his gate, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. So it was that the beggar died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And being in torments, Hades, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. Then he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, but for I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that in your lifetime you received your good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things, but now he is comforted, and you are tormented. And besides all this, between us and you there is a great gulf fixed, so that those who want to pass from here to you cannot, nor can those from there pass to us. Then he said, I beg you therefore, Father, that you would send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, that he may testify to them, lest they also come to this place of torment. Abraham said to him, They have Moses and prophets. Let them hear them. And he said, No, Father Abraham, but if one goes to them from the dead, they will repent. But he said to him, If they do not hear Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded through one rise from the dead. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
We've heard our gospel reading over and over and over again, probably at least once a year. But I know that when this is shared, sometimes this scripture is referenced to when somebody is wondering if when you die you immediately go to heaven or... And I know that this is referenced in saying, look, Lazarus went right to Abraham's bosom. Like, So he wasn't any different than the thief on the cross when Jesus said, "Today you will be in paradise with me." We tend to always want to focus on the good. We can't ignore that the rich man went to Hades and was in torment, right? We can't forget that there's a heaven and a hell. Many times in these days, people try to just preach on the good stuff. As a matter of fact, I heard about a pastor belonged to a church in Tulsa back in 2008. He preached in church. His name was Charles, I think it was Charles Pearson. But he preached in church that there was no hell in 2008. And what happened in that congregation is that many of them got up and walked out. The sad part is, if that, and he still preaches, by the way, he has a book out. I couldn't really read the title, but it's something like, "Hell No, Get Hell Out of the Bible." He's still preaching today. The sad part is that people that hear that today would probably flock to his church. Because that's what they want to hear. You know, the Bible tells us that they will want to hear that your itching of the ears is that people want to hear what they want to hear. And sometimes we as preachers just want to say what people want to hear. And that's the good stuff. Amen? But today, I really felt like I should focus on the warn them. You see, first of all, I want to point out, the rich man did not go to Hades because he was rich, okay? I feel like we're always talking about rich people and people that have money, and money is the root of all evil. But the rich man didn't go to Hades because he was rich. He went to Hades because he didn't have a heart. And when I first read that, the first thought that came to my mind was the movie that I love. It's either Scrooge the Musical or Christmas Carol, right? That's a redemption story, amen? So Ebenezer didn't have a heart, right? We can picture that in the movie, right? He didn't have a heart. He didn't care about nothing else except for himself and his money. And it seemed to me, after reading the scripture, that this rich man was the same. I mean, he had somebody that was filled with sores begging him for crumbs, and he refused to give it to him. That was pointing to his heart. He was heartless. And if we look at the Christmas Carol, and Ebenezer being heartless, he was granted his partner to come back and warn him. Remember? Marley came back and he's like carrying all these heavy chains on him, and he's moaning and he's groaning and he's telling Ebenezer, "Ebenezer, you need to change your ways. Because if you don't, you're going to have chains even longer than me." But the thing is, you know, we can imagine those chains being heavy and we can imagine carrying them along for eternity. But our scripture tells us it's way worse than that. It's not chains. It's fire. It is fire, torment. Think about that. Being in torment every second of the day for eternity. And this rich man, he's like, "Okay, I'm here, but you need to go tell my brothers. Because I have five brothers, And we can imagine what he's thinking. They're just like me. And I don't want them to come here. Did you ever have somebody that was like just doing all wrong all the time? You know? And they say, well, it doesn't matter. Because I'm going to hell anyways. Do you ever have somebody tell you that? I have. And if anybody tells you that, use the scripture, because it is way worse than you ever would imagine. But this rich man wanted somebody to go and warn his brothers, just like Marvin did. But the answer to that was no. We can't do that. First of all, anybody from heaven can't go to Hades, and anybody from Hades can't go to heaven. And it doesn't have anything to do with being rich or poor. And I just realized that we prayed that in our prayer, and I was like, wait a second, that doesn't sound quite right. You can't get that. But in the movie, you see, Scrooge was allowed to see his past, allowed to see his present, and allowed to see what's going to happen to him. And because of all that, he finally got heart. And at the end of the movie, aren't you all excited? Like, I remember watching Scrooge the musical, because I like the music and the songs. Just like at the end of the movie, it was like you were just all giddy and happy and just like, woohoo, changed. Reflecting the joy that God puts in our hearts when we realize that we've been redeemed, amen? And we all have that chance. We all have that choice. But did you hear why the person in our scripture was denied that request? It was said that they were already told that they had Moses and they had the prophets and they had God's word telling them what they should do and what they shouldn't do. And if they chose to not do what they were being asked to do, then that was it. And if they didn't listen to the prophets, they weren't going to listen to somebody that was risen from the dead. We need to listen to the prophets. We need to listen to what God has to say. Not only what's in his word, but also the word that he feeds to us through his spirit. Amen? We have all heard God's voice. Amen? Has anybody heard God's voice? One way or another. Maybe not audible. But he's laid something on your heart to tell you what was right and what was wrong. Or to tell you, ask you to do something. Or, you know, somebody comes and asks you for help and he says, go ahead, help them. We need to listen to his warnings. And through our scripture today, we're hearing a warning. So we need to continue to tell that warning to the world. Amen? There is so much stuff out there that is telling our children differently. Okay? And one of the things that I just heard this past week was there's two young girls that I know from, you know, being raised up in the church, and they're still young and they're still in school, but they have gotten to the point where they don't believe in the Word of God. And I said, how did they get there? Like, who's feeding them this stuff? said social media. That is disturbing to me. That tells me that we, the church, aren't doing our job. That we aren't letting the rest of the world know the secret that's in His Word. Redemption. I know when I had my first daughter, and somebody says nobody gives you an instruction book when you have a child. And I felt that that wasn't true. Because I felt that this was the best instruction book that I had ever gotten. So let us be in the Word. Let us know the Word. And let us share it. Amen. Please join with me in prayer. Oh, dear Heavenly Father, you have given us an example of the good and the bad. Of the torment for eternity or the joy for eternity. I know, dear Lord, that you speak to our hearts. So I ask you, dear Lord, to speak to ours and help us to know what is right and what is wrong. But mostly, dear Lord, help us to help those that don't know you to come to know you even more or better or just come to know you. Let's not leave it up to Franklin Graham to bring people to you. Let us be your instruments so that we can all be giddy with that joy that you bring to us, dear Lord, and rejoice once again with the angels in heaven and you. And this I pray, dear Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.
I'm
I pray that God puts somebody in your path this week that doesn't have him in their heart, so that you can share the joy that he brings, so that they can receive him in their heart. Amen?
Amen.
May the peace and grace of Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the guidance of the Holy Spirit be with all of